A Christmas road tragedy, a grandmother and her grandchild are dead. A man and another child are fighting for life after an horrific car accident. 6 a.m. Thursday, the 22nd of December. Good morning, everyone. I'm Ron Wilson.
And I'm Ellie Southwood. Welcome to 10's Early News. Also this morning, talking turkey. The federal government and opposition talk up their willingness to negotiate the offshore processing of asylum seekers over Christmas.
In sport, Test debutant in waiting, Ed Cowan, still pinching himself after being called up to open for the Aussies in the Boxing Day Test.
And in finance, Europe's banks snap up nearly half a trillion euros in cheap three-year loans to help bail out struggling economies.
Here's a check of today's weather. Not great on the east coast with showers headed for Brisbane and Sydney, but it's looking good elsewhere with mostly sunny conditions for Melbourne, Adelaide and Perth. A toddler and her grandmother have been killed in a horror crash when their vehicle hit a street sweeper in Sydney's west. A man and another child are fighting for life in hospital.
The wreckage of this family four-wheel drive is barely recognisable after it crashed into a stationary street sweeping machine after 9 p.m. last night. A grandmother and a child just 2 years old were killed. A man and another child are fighting for life in hospital. A third child survived and is uninjured. A sedan was also involved in the crash, but no one in that car was injured.
All too often police are exposed to these circumstances, and it's a tragedy that looks like it's torn a family apart at this time of the year.
Emergency service workers had to cut the man and the surviving children from the wreckage before they were rushed to Westmead Hospital in a critical condition. Police can't yet confirm whether all the occupants of the car members of the one family.
But it's a timely reminder for police to remind motorists, especially at this time of year, at Christmas and New Year, to slow down, drive to the road conditions.
Police are still examining the cause of the accident. Jessica Turner, 10 News.
Three Indonesian soldiers are being investigated over their alleged involvement in the Java asylum seeker tragedy. Meanwhile, the federal government and the opposition have promised to work over Christmas if necessary, if it means finding a solution to the offshore processing deadlock.
As Christmas approaches, Labor and the Coalition seem to be joining in the spirit of goodwill.
How are you going to spend Christmas Day?
Well, I'm happy to spend it negotiating on this issue.
I'm happy to have turkey with Tony Abbott on Christmas Day, but first we've got to talk turkey.
But it's just talk, with Mr Abbott insisting a meeting is pointless right now.
If the only specific proposal they've got is Malaysia, well, we talked about that in the Parliament 9 weeks ago and we said no.
Well, there is a point in meeting. People's lives are at stake.
The Leader of the Opposition is coming under pressure from within, a senior Coalition member publicly declaring a deal with Malaysia could work.
If Labor were prepared to make further changes in discussion with Malaysia, there may be other ways in which the principle that we've argued could be met.
But Mr Abbott insists there's no split in his ranks.
Effectively, Philip is restating our position.
Mr Bowen hopes egos aren't getting in the way of good policy. But with no one showing any sign of giving in, the only certainty is more boats will come and more people will risk their lives.
We've had two tragedies in the last month. This is what's driven our policy. It's what's driven me for 12 months to try and get a proper regional framework up so we don't have to go through this as a nation anymore.
Matt Moran, 10 News.
Music icon Ian Molly Meldrum has made another sign of progress. Doctors downgraded his status from critical to serious but stable. Fans, delighted by the news, joined Melbourne Storm players to send messages of hope to the big screen at Melbourne's Federation Square.
It's great news, but it's very early days, but it's certainly all heading in the right direction.
Molly remains in intensive care and is expected to undergo surgery for his chest and shoulder injuries over the next few days. North Korea's new leader is expected to share power with an uncle and the military. Kim Jong-un has taken over the family dynasty from his father, Kim Jong-il, who died of a heart attack over the weekend. Little is known about the 28-year-old, but sources close to Pyongyang and Beijing say the country will move to collective rule. The military has reportedly given its backing to Kim Jong-un. It comes as South Korean activists launch giant balloons across the border, carrying leaflets criticising the power succession. Tens of thousands of women may have their breast implants removed after a particular type of implant was linked to a rare cancer. Authorities in France and Australia are taking the risk seriously, but British doctors are playing down the link.
Annick Desjoie had breast implants made by Poly Implant Prothèse. 3 years after surgery, they ruptured. She had more fitted, but they too were faulty.
C'était très grande fatigue.
The symptoms were tiredness, she says. I started to notice swollen glands, in particular on the side of my left breast. I was frightened. I thought I was sick.
Sur le côté gauche en l'occurrence.
Implants from PIP are now causing even greater alarm in France. Officials are warning they may be linked to a rare form of cancer after 9 patients were diagnosed with it. Women there are being told to seek advice if their silicon came from PIP. For 40,000 women here with such implants, the advice is very different.
All we can say is that we've looked at this thoroughly. We've done all the tests that we think are absolutely necessary, and we can find no safety issues.
PIP went into administration last year and all use of its implants banned. The silicon used wasn't regulated and thought to have been made for mattress filling. French authorities will announce on Friday whether to tell women who have PIP implants to have them removed. If they do, it could have far-reaching implications across the world.
The official death toll from the Philippines typhoon has risen to more than 1,000. Authorities have begun the grim process of trying to identify bodies, while morgues are working around the clock to prevent a disease outbreak. Hundreds of families have lost everything in the flash floods and landslides. Many are spending a fifth day camped at a gymnasium, which has been turned into an evacuation centre in the country's south. Leaders from around the world are expected to attend tomorrow's state funeral for former Czech president and anti-communism hero Václav Havel. Tens of thousands of mourners crammed around his hearse as it made its way to Prague Castle. His flag-draped casket was escorted by an honour guard to the place where he served more than 12 years as president. The revolutionary leader is remembered for his role in rebuilding Eastern Europe and ending communist rule in the former Czechoslovakia. He died on Sunday at the age of 75. The world's largest menorah has been lit in New York City, marking the start of the Jewish holiday of Hanukkah. Hundreds packed Central Park for the much-anticipated event. In Washington, D.C., another giant menorah was lit outside the White House. One candle will be lit on each of the celebration's 8 days. It's a tradition dating back to the 2nd century B.C. Hanukkah commemorates the rededication of the Holy Temple in Jerusalem. Sports News and selectors have named a 13-man squad for the first cricket test, with Sean Marsh and Dan Christian vying for a batting spot. Newcomer Ed Cowan has been assured he'll open the innings following the axing of Philip Hughes and Usman Khawaja, while recalling Ben Hilfenhaus gives selectors another bowling option.
He's the new face at the top of the order. The bearded run machine still coming to terms with his promotion.
Instant reaction was shock. You know, the hairs on your arm stand up and it doesn't quite sink in, and it still hasn't.
4 centuries in his last 4 matches, Cowan's flush of form continued with a ton for the chairman's 11 against India. But the 29-year-old insists his selection is not limited to the latest rash of runs.
Got 9 first-class hundreds in the last 2.5 years, so it's not 400s in 4 weeks and all of a sudden you're in the test team.
I think in the side we need a bit more steadiness. And we're looking to Ed to provide that.
At the Nets, paceman James Pattinson gave Ricky Ponting a sample of his stinging deliveries. The former skipper left shaking, but no lasting damage. By any measure, Shane Watson's calf injury was too much of a risk, while Sean Marsh still has to prove his fitness after a back injury. Charles Christian, 10 News.
The all-important long-range weather forecast for the Sydney to Hobart yacht race will be released today. Crews have been put through safety training drills. Race favourite Wild Oats 11's crew well aware of the dangers.
I did the 98 Hobart and it's still very fresh in my mind, you know, about the situations that can arise.
Wild Oats 11 is aiming to take line honours in the Blue Water Classic for the 6th time in 7 starts. England football captain John Terry will face criminal charges for racially abusing Queen's Park Rangers player Anton Ferdinand. The 31-year-old has been formally charged by the Crown Prosecution Service. However, he denies he made any racial comments and is vowing to clear his name. The verbal exchange occurred during Chelsea's 1-0 loss to Rangers in October. Time now for all the morning's finance news with Ellie Southwood. And now we're hearing that the nation is in the grip of a housing crisis.
There aren't enough homes, Ron, to go around. Demand for housing across the nation outstripped supply by 186,000 dwellings this year. That's up an extra 28,000 on last year. The report by the National Housing Supply Council also revealed the gap between supply and demand could reach 640,000 dwellings by 2030. The council found the increasing need for single-person dwellings as the population ages will be one of the major factors behind the crisis. Another key problem is house prices outstripping wage growth. House prices in most capital cities have more than doubled over the past decade. One of the nation's best wine-producing regions will be spared a coal mine. The West Australian government has upheld an Environmental Protection Agency decision to reject a proposed coal mine near Margaret River. The mine was rejected over concerns to the aquifers in the region, which would affect grape growing and tourism. Gerry Harvey has moved to boost market confidence in his company by spending $1 million to buy shares in Harvey Norman. Mr. Harvey says his company's share price of $1.88 is good value despite the extremely tough conditions retailers are facing. He also believes consumers will spend up during the post-Christmas sales and expects online competition to soften. Taking a look at the global markets now, and after solid gains yesterday, stocks have taken a backward step over continuing concerns about Europe and some US data which showed the country's housing market recession was worse than first thought. The Dow Jones is down 47 points. The Nasdaq has also been dragged lower after Oracle, the world's third largest software maker, posted weaker than expected profits. In Europe and all the main markets were lower because investors got worried when banks quickly snapped up cheap central bank loans. The take-up rate was much higher than expected, suggesting the banks are on shaky ground and may not use the money to buy up the region's debt. To Asia, the Nikkei closed in positive territory, up 123 points. To the commodities, and oil is higher this morning, trading at $98 a barrel. Gold is down. The Australian dollar is slightly above parity with the US. It's also buying 77 euro cents. Our market closed in positive territory yesterday, but the SPY is pointing to a weaker day today.
There are the national weather details on your screen. A possible shower in Brisbane today, top of 28. A late shower for Sydney, 23 the top. Sunny in Melbourne, 28. Lovely. Adelaide, mostly sunny and a top of 32. And a sunny day for Perth with 31 degrees.